In this video, we'll be taking a look at the merry world of Christmas trains. These unusual and highly decorated trains tend to appear a couple of months before Christmas each year. But be warned, a $50 train set that you purchase before Christmas can turn into a $10 train set after Christmas. Ugh, but do we really need Christmas trains? Can you just dress up any train and have it under your Christmas tree? This video will examine a number of Christmas trains found in Sydney, Australia. And there'll be some top advice on how to turn a very inexpensive remote-controlled, large-scale train into something very Christmassy. Ugh, don't worry, I'm only doing the intro. My name's Gloria Chuchu. Enjoy the video.
Well, hi everyone. We're going to do a video about Christmas trains, aren't we? Do you like Christmas trains?
Yeah.
Do you like lots of Christmas trains? Are you going to tell me which ones are the good ones and the bad ones?
Yeah.
Let's do it. I'll be taking a look at the North Pole Express. This is purchased from Target Australia for $69. There's another train here called the North Pole Express from K-Mart for $45. Here's a Christmas train from Costco. It's just called Classic Train New Series, and it was $44.99. You might as well call that $45. And maybe as a reality check, I will pull out this Black Canyon Express, $59 from K-Mart Australia. And the interesting part to this one, well, it's not really a Christmas train, but it is remote controlled. So that's quite a lineup of trains to look at in this video, and I'll be very curious to see which one of those trains will also suit my Newqida G scale clone train there, which was most impressive. Lots of people ask about this remote control train, and I still do see it in the shops. You can buy a complete set with tracks and other carriages, and it's around $200. So it's a $69 train versus a $45 train versus what is basically another $45 train versus a $59 train. And what I'll do is I'll throw up some footage of some Christmas trains that I saw in store, and it's really buyer beware. Boy, it's easy to get up near the $100 mark. You can start seeing them punch up near the $200 mark, and you sort of wonder yourself, well, what's going on here? Is it a Christmas tax, or are these trains really worth $100, $200 and whatever? I know the audience knows about these trains. I've certainly got bitten last year when I bought a very cheap one from Kmart, and it kept jumping the rails and it kept skipping gears inside the train. It was actually very annoying, and it made it very difficult to make my Christmas train video for last year. Which train would you like to look at first? Yeah, the $69 Target Christmas train. One thing about this one, it's got very impressive packaging. When it was in store, my son loved to open it up, take a good look at the train inside, and you can press the button to get some sounds. Where have I heard that sound before? Well, there's another DMCA for my channel. What will be interesting is how similar that train there is to the Kmart one, which was a fair bit cheaper. Remembering in Australia that Kmart and Target, well, they're basically owned by the same company. Just getting an unboxing shot here because they're really important to get, I believe. If you don't have one of these in the video, well, it's just not an unboxing, is it? Well, here it is, still inside a box, but out of its box. There's two straight pieces of track there, bit of a caboose and whatever. There's the curves, there's some more straight pieces of track here. These are some little signs, and looks like there's a sticker sheet here, very Christmassy, and all that train boogie to go on, a set of instructions there. Next time you see this, it'll be out of the box and up and running. Okay, our $69 from Target Australia Christmas train, North Pole Express, is up and running. My son is just setting up some signs, and it looks very Christmassy. It looks very fine and train dandy. There's some lovely gold detailing on the locomotive there. It's got a light on the front. It's making lots of Christmas sounds. It looked fantastic under your tree. And what's interesting, in the box it had that press button that you detach from the locomotive, and that's now the bomb. My son said that's the bomb for the train. Is that right?
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe those Christmas sounds would, I don't know, drive you up the wall. Some people may love them. Joy to the world. The train with the noise has come. What you can do, the stop and start button is there, and you can actually turn the sounds off via the bell there, which will give it a run without the sounds, I think. But it's a dangerous railway because there could be things put on the track and people trying to sabotage the train. Oh no, someone's put signs on the track, as little boys do. Oh, this could be unstoppable. Oh, it's a train wreck. That is definitely a train wreck, and we will come in and take a look at the wheels while the train is off the rails. This train takes 4C batteries that are inside the cab there, so that's an extra expense on this train. Underneath here, when it was in box, that's where the button plugs in underneath. That gives you the train sound so you can hear them in box. It's a bit of, I don't know, extra stuff that you really don't need. But on this train here, you have traction tires. And what I've found with these cheaper trains is this is where the problems lie over a couple of years. It ends up those traction tires basically just blow off the wheels. But I dare say the fun of that little button is my son believes it's a bomb button to blow up the train. So maybe it has got a purpose in life apart from turning on the annoying train sounds. Look, it's a nicely decorated Christmas train. It's fairly basic. It does couple together fairly easily. That's not going to for me now. You can couple it together. Play hard to get. You know, they're a bit rock and rolly, the carriages, but that sort of looks nice sometimes. And the caboose is sort of nice. I suppose you could squeeze in some little characters in there to dress it up a bit more. There's no detail inside that at all, but that's very typical of this type of toy. So it's getting a run without its carriages. It sort of does the same speed. What's your thoughts about that Christmas train set there for $69 in Target Australia? Hey, let's look at something from Kmart. I think it's a very similar set for $45. Well, I've got a funny feeling the main difference between this one and a Target train is there's one less carriage in this. I think there's a little bit less track, although when we get it set up, we're going to notice things, aren't we? And on this one, there's a bit of a synopsis here. It's the same 4C batteries to power this. It really does look very similar indeed. Getting an unboxing shot here. It's got some silver detailing on this train. It only makes a circle, the track here. That looks very familiar, doesn't it? And there is the tender. I also noticed we've got some little signs to put on here, and it looks like the same sticker sheet, doesn't it? And this is also Easy Tech, so this track would marry into that train over there. And also that train over there. Well, this Kmart Christmas train looks identical in shape to the Target one. This is where the batteries go, inside where the driver sits. And it really is child's play putting batteries in. Okay, we've got our $45 Christmas train up and running, and looks like the other one is running as well, but we'll concentrate on that Kmart one first. I've asked for the sounds to be off because the sounds were doing my head in. Some nice gear whirring sounds there from those trains. Well, I dare say I can see the difference. We're one less carriage in this train. We've got less track. We haven't got the straights. But nevertheless, it's still an impressive Christmas train for $45. So the difference between that Christmas train there and this Christmas train over here is $24. Geez, I hope I'm right there. I asked my wife to do that maths because it was a little bit too much for me to work out. But I dare say the big question is, can you see the $24 difference between those two trains? Which train do you like? Which one do you like? Both of them. I thought he'd say that. Oh, watch out. Looks like we've got some signs being put on the track here. Could be a disaster. Could be a disaster. Whoa. And it's another train wreck. And while this train is on its side, let's see if it has that detail where you plug in the bomb. Oh no, look at that. It's not there. You can't plug it in, or you're going to try to, aren't you? Yeah. We're pretend bombing the train, as children do.
I got bombing.
Okay, bomb. Okay, which train would you like to look at next?
The white one.
The white one. Ooh, nice choice. Hey, before we look at the white one, do you want to join the carriages from that choo-choo over there to this choo-choo here and make a giant Christmas choo-choo?
Yeah!
Okay, turn on the giant Christmas train. Oh yeah, and it's doing it with ease. It's got double tenders there, double caboose or brake van, depending on what part of the world you're in. And it looks mighty fine and mighty dandy. Oh yeah. She'll be coming around the Christmas tree when she comes. She'll be coming around the Christmas tree when she comes. She'll be coming around the Christmas tree, coming around the Christmas tree, coming around the Christmas tree when she comes. Yahoo! That was crazy, wasn't it? Yeah, the son didn't like that. He preferred to hear the Christmas tree. There's actually one little problem. I wouldn't call it a problem, but we've noticed the bit of detail that we keep forgetting about this train is there's a little wheel at the front there. I think it's called the pony wheel or whatever. It's very hard to see, and it's very hard to see when it comes off, and it's very hard to actually put on. We all love the Christmas train. Choo-choo. I'll do a bit of a train crash here. Whoa! Whoa! That was fun, let's do it again. Whoa, whoa. One last time, I can't help myself. Whoa, whoa. That was the best so far, and it's still going.
Can I can't help myself.
So it looks like that Tajay Christmas train smacked down the K-Mart one every time. As you can see, this video is being derailed. No pun intended. Let's get onto the white Costco Christmas train. Okay, this is the Costco Christmas train. You basically call that $45. What is interesting about this one, it actually comes with the batteries. If I look at the back of the box read here, here's a synopsis of coupling the train together, assembling the track, and it talks about there's batteries in this packaging. Also talks about working headlight and sounds, which is probably going to scare me. Let's get this train out of the box. The boys had a great day of unboxing trains today. Well, there's a look at the train. It, I don't know, to me it just feels a little bit lighter and cheaper, if that's possible, to the other ones. There's the tender. There's its carriages. I have to investigate the track to see if it is the same as the EasyTech or a G-Scale track. And of course, I've got batteries in here. Okay, I better build this one up. And before I build it, there's one very interesting detail here. Look how chunky the traction tire on this train here is. It's in the middle wheel. That's a chunky traction tire if ever I've seen one. In this Costco Christmas train, there's a double stack of batteries. There's six double A's all up. It's the only one which came with batteries, which is sort of nice. And sure, the Costco train came with batteries and it looks fine and dandy and Christmassy, but there is a bugbear here that is annoying me for the fact that the track which came with the Costco train is not G-Scale. It's actually a little bit wider. The EasyTech track is G-Scale. This is the Newqida track from the clone LGB train, which is beautiful. And if I put this over the top of this one here, you can see there's actually quite a difference in gauge there. And you'll probably see, if I put that on top there, you can see that as well. So that track there is lining up on that side, and you can see the difference down here of the larger scale of the Costco track. So sadly, that beautiful Christmas train there can't run with the Kmart or Target trains that we looked at previously. Okay, we're ready to start our $45 Costco Christmas train. And away it goes. Looking fine, Christmas and dandy. Is that smoke coming out the top?
Yeah.
It's got smoke. Look at that. Well, that certainly raises it up in the stakes of Christmas trains. And it's a fair effect, I tell you. It looks pretty good. Where have we heard that sound chip before? Sounds very familiar, doesn't it? If you've been watching my knockoff toy stuff, you'll know that sound chip. Well, I'm not sure how much you'll hear me over the train noise, but there is our $45 Costco Christmas train. It's quite a nice circuit. It's got smoke, but unfortunately the track is not G-Scale. There's our $45 EasyTech Kmart Christmas train. It's only a circuit there, a circle circuit. It's missing sort of wagons. It doesn't do much for me, that one. And here is our $69 Christmas train for EasyTech again, G-Scale. In a strange way, I actually don't mind that one. But the real question is, to my audience, which one of these trains presents the best value? They're just Christmas trains, they tend to be a bit overpriced, they tend to be, well, not made very well. They're a bit of Christmas fun. I suppose you bring them out one time of the year and then you pack them away for the rest of the year. What's your thoughts on Christmas trains? My son pointed out a neat feature on the Costco one, the fact that you can load in lollies and stuff into one of the wagons here, which is a nice little feature to have. Okay, let's send it on its way. So there is one thing that that Christmas train can do that the others can't, the fact you can load up some chockies, or you could put a gift in there as well if you wanted to, and it makes it that little bit more special. Just on this Costco Christmas train, I'm not sure you can see it, but the front wheel tends to ride up. That middle wheel with the traction tire tends to be like a pivot point. I'll try and get some better video of that so you can see the front wheel. And hopefully you can see that now, that front flange is totally exposed on the front wheel there of the train. But there's another aspect my son pointed out to me. Notice the smoke effect has stopped. And what's curious about that smoke effect was there's nothing on the box read about that smoke effect. I've looked all over that box and even on the back it says nothing about smoke. So I better come in and we'll stop it and we'll investigate exactly what's going on there. I've got a little bit of baby oil here, not much. I'll just tinkle a bit in the top here and that might give us back our effect. Do you want to turn the train on? I'll hold it. We'll look for the smoke effect. Okay, turn it on. Okay, we'll see if we get that smoke effect back. It looks like we've got the smoke effect back. I just tickled some baby oil down that hole there. And away it goes. Smoke effect and all. Well, we'll give the Costco train a bit of a rest because there's a few other train sets that I want to show you. When we're thinking about trains, you can put under your Christmas tree. On the thought of Christmas trains, do you remember when I looked at the Limax Christmas train a couple of years back? It's gone up a bit in price, $50 now. Nevertheless, it's a nicely detailed, smaller scale Christmas train. But do you need to look like a Christmas train to be a Christmas train? I've got a funny feeling I could put any of these trains under a Christmas tree, and if you put a little bit of Christmas dingle on them, you could have something which is very Christmassy and maybe something that can be used in other times of the year. I'm pretty sure that basic Thomas Trackmaster set could be put under a Christmas tree to much effect. This Tomi Tomica set is from a couple of years ago. It was $35 at Big W. They're very hard to find in Australia, but it'd make a fantastic Christmas train. At the mid-year toy sales in Australia at Big W, I noticed this Easy Tech bullet train. It was only $30. I think it looks fantastic. I mean, why can't you have a modern train as a Christmas train? I can't see any problem with that. This is another large set. It was bought from Costco in 2014. It looks fantastic. It was a great price, $38.98. Again, I can't see any problem with having that under a Christmas tree. And I really think this My Little Pony train, this is a very hard playset to find. There was a smaller version of this getting about, but I think you could put that under a Christmas tree without any problem at all, and everyone would be happy. But I think a great train set to set up against the Christmas trains is this Black Canyon Express. It's G-Scale, it's Easy Tech. It was $59 at Kmart, and maybe this will start to expose the Christmas train tax. You want to get into the Black Canyon Express, don't you? This is actually the third one we've got of this train set. What's interesting about this Easy Tech train versus that one there which is $69. This is $59. So it's cheaper is that it's got 12 curved and 8 straight, whereas this one over here has 12 curved and 4 straight. So in the Black Canyon Express, we're going to get more straight track.
Help.
You want some help, do you? Sorry, I was yabbering, wasn't I? Pull her out, pull her out. But I think the best way to see the difference is to set them up. Lay it down, lay the box down. Set them up and you'll see it much clearer. Pull, pull. Great unboxing shot, this one, go. Keep pulling. All the strength in it, go, go, go. That's a great big train set. Whoa. So there's all the straight tracks. There's the curved. There's locomotive, black and beautiful. There is the tender, and these are the wagons that come with this train. Here is the remote control, which is what makes it different to the other trains that we've looked at. And the signs there, interesting, the signs are not Christmas themed. It just says Great Railway Company, and the other signs are very similar. There's some instructions, and what is interesting is, if this is a Christmas train as remote controlled, oh boy, you could be punching up near the $200 mark easy. Time to get the choo-choos out. You notice anything familiar about that one there? In this video, notice the same sort of style and shape? Gold railings and stuff? Hey, look at that. What's that there? It's a hair. Is it like a hair from China?
No.
It's black, it's straight.
That was my hair.
I don't think it's your hair. Your hair isn't, what I last looked, black and straight. Well, there's a look at that hair. I dare say the audience can work out where that hair came from. Why don't you let me know? Well, the train running in at the moment is the Newqida LGB clone. It's a very nice train. I've had that for a couple of years now. My son obviously absolutely loves it. Its remote control looks like this. I suppose it's El Cheapo remote control, but you can make the train go fairly fast. Remember, it's not running on its native track, it's running on EasyTech track here. It's actually got a bit of wheel slippage on this track as well. And I can slide right up. Oh, bit of slippage there, I can go backwards. You can get some nice slower speeds if you're very careful on the remote. And I mean very careful. Yeah, a bit of wheel sliding there, and go forward again. Oh yeah. My son loves that. He loves skidding. And you could do it all day long and never ever get bored, would you? And like I might have said, that's the sort of train, if you look around for it, if you're getting it for about $200, it comes with it quite an extensive layout. It comes with a whole bunch of wagons and stuff. It's actually a pretty good buy if you can pick it up for around $200. And what's nice about the Newqida track versus the EasyTech is you can get some points. I've actually painted this up to make it look more realistic. But nevertheless, because you've got sets of points, you end up with a much nicer railway. Just been reminded it has got its sound chip as well. And if my boy had his way, he'd be playing at that train all day long. But what I think is really important to say is I've had that train for a while now and it really hasn't presented any problems. And what I'll do is I'll bring the train around here slowly and we'll turn this one off. Even its off button is cleverly disguised. Well, let's talk about the Black Canyon Express and not the Newqida. I've had, this is the third one I've just opened in this video. That was my second one. I know the problems that go on with these trains. The first problem I see going on is the track system, the fact that part of the track, that joins it is easily broken off. This piece of track has lost its joiner from both sides. It's very brittle in that sense. Okay, so that's the track problem. The problem with the trains, well, the first one I had the gears basically stripped out of it very fast, but I may have just been very unlucky. But one thing I do notice that goes on is the traction tires basically come off, and once they're gone, they basically deteriorate would be the best word for it. Once they're gone, this train tends to just want to skid on the rails. And what it should look like is this brand new one here. There it is there with its traction tires which are on. But I've actually noticed there's been a design change, so someone's doing some thinking. This one here you can't get into the cabin. They've made the cabin area here where the driver would be. This is now the battery compartment. It's just like those Christmas trains. Whereas my earlier version, and I've had this for maybe just over a year now, you can see there it's got some cabin detail. The batteries was in the tender. And I think there's now only four batteries needed. Before, this train needed six batteries. Would you like to remove that Newqida G-Scale train and we'll get the Black Canyon Express batteried up, connected up, and up and running? Oh yes, looks familiar, doesn't it? It takes four C-size batteries. I do like the fact that the batteries are in a locomotive and it's got rid of one very annoying aspect to the old style, which was this plug here, which could be very problematic at the best of times. Okay, it's now or never. I'll turn it on. My son's got the remote control because this one's remote control and the train is away. Oh yeah, looking fine and dandy. So the Black Canyon Express has got backwards there, it's got sound, oh, and the back caboose has come off. In fact, we're broken away there. I'm sure my son will come and fix that. So what do you think? $59 for that, it's basically $10 cheaper than that Christmas train over there for $69. $59 again, remote control. Looks pretty big, doesn't it? $69. Not remote control, but it's a Christmassy thing. That train there is the cheapest. It's the Costco Christmas train. $44.99. $1 more. $45 buys the K-Mart Christmas train, the Easy Tech version of it. Then I suppose the next cheapest along is this one here. For $59 you get the Black Canyon Express. It's big, it's remote controlled, it's beautiful, but it's not Christmassy, is it? Oh my, this will be a strange train accident there. Almost. And the next one, and the most expensive on this video, is this one here. $69, the Target Christmas train. It's not remote controlled. It's very Christmassy, I dare say. It's all about buy beware. And that's a whole ton of train boogie going on the back of the house today, I'll tell you. Looks like there's trouble over there on the Costco train. My son is fixing it up. Black Canyon Express has been nice and reliable. My son's having a bit more fun of it there, laying in front of the train. Don't do that with real trains, boys and girls. It can be very life-threatening. The K-Mart Christmas train's a bit of the quiet achiever in this video. It's like piggy in the middle in a sense. And the Target Christmas train's lesson is probably, well, maybe it pays to shop around a bit when you're buying trains around Christmas time. Mind you, there might be some people out there who absolutely love what that train has to offer. Well, notice the smoke effect on this doesn't actually last too long after putting a couple of drops in there. We will get it up and running again. And what's in there is a couple of drops of baby oil. Well, the Costco train has come off the rails again. It's been doing a bit of that actually. And I think it's because it has that front wheel which rides very high on the rails. I don't think we worked out how to turn the sound off on that Costco train either, although the squeaking wheels is probably the most annoying sound of that train. Which train do you like the best? Tell me which one. Which is your favourite train? I just want you to pick one train. Which one's your favourite? Very important, pick this one. Think very carefully.
Choose a Christmas one.
Because it's Christmas, near Christmas, you're going to choose a Christmas one. Well, which one do you like the best? I'm not going to provoke him in this. I want me to tell us which one he thinks is the best. Well, there we go. The target train has been given the award. Interesting, isn't it? So the $69 target Christmas train, which I really thought presented maybe the least value, but then again, you are getting a bit of a bigger train set, is my son's favorite.
I got the bomb.
And he likes it also because it's got that bomb. And that was just a little trigger that triggered the sound in box. That's all that thing did. But he treats it like a bomb for the train.
There's a bomb there.
And there he is playing, bombing the train. Hey, tell me which train, let's say if it's not Christmas time, oh, this is a pretty easy choice, which train is your favorite when it's not Christmas?
The black one.
The black one, which is this one here. Oh yeah. You know, it's funny, I know most of our audience, they have Christmas time in winter, in the coldest time of the year, but in Australia, it's summertime, so I'm making this video. It's been so hot today. My boy has been very good. We've been out in the heat, and I can't wait to get back inside the air conditioning, but we've been very hot, haven't we? Very hot. You like the trains? We're all sweaty, aren't we? Yeah. Come to Australia, if you get cold in wintertime, up in the Northern Hemisphere, up in Europe or the USA, come down here, it's nice and warm. Well, there was my bit for the Australian Tourism Commission. I hope they appreciate it. Can you please turn the trains off? And we'll have our final bit to say in this video, which I'm really pleased I got around to doing this year. Thank you. It was fun getting all those trains, wasn't it? Yeah, and it was also fun for me to go shopping for them. Like I said earlier in the video, I could have gone and got trains up near the $200 mark, basically, which were Christmas versions of this train here, but I wasn't going to crack that much money to show in a video. I think I've got my point across here in this video. I know some people will say, well, this Black Canyon Express isn't a Christmas train, but you know, I could add one thing to this train and turn it into a Christmas train. And I think I saw it in a Thomas and Friends episode, one of the Christmas episodes, where one of the diesels was covered in Christmas lights. You could string a set of Christmas lights over this train and whammo, it becomes a Christmas train. The Costco train to me was a bit disappointing. It did jump the rails a few times. I think you could see the problem here. Basically rocks on that middle traction wheel. You can see that. It looks nice. It's very Christmassy. For the fact it's got this open wagon and you can put chocolates in here, I'll just prove you how hot it is. Look at that. The chocolates are just all... Oh! There we go. Summertime in Australia, guys. You don't don't play up chocolates, do you? The Kmart Australia train was pretty good for what it is, $45. It's easy tech. It didn't jump the rails. That set can marry up to the Black Canyon Express if I wanted to. Hey, not bad for $45. And the Australian Target Christmas train, same company as Kmart Australia, but it did have the more ritzy and a little bit more pricey Christmas train, which ended up being my son's favorite. And the main reason is because it's got that bomb button. Well, there's the Black Canyon Express, and I've had a few of them. I know the problems that go on with those. They seem like great bang for buck. But I think if you're prepared to spend just a little bit more money and you buy these sets, and if you can get the Newqida for around $200 and you get a great train set, you get an interesting train set for the fact you get sets of points as well. Make sure when you buy the set, it has the proper layout, like when I purchased mine. It's nice detailing. The remote control is nice on it. You can get some nice slow speeds and some nice high speeds on it. If you want to, you can set it up outdoors without any problem. And really, out of all the trains that I've got out here, this is the one that impresses my boy the most. It's the one that he gets most excited about. Got all sorts of nice details, and now it's got a bomb on the top. Hey, you know what it's time to say? Thanks for watching, and...
Bye for now. Bye.
Oh, and it's the tongue. Do you want me to leave all the trains out here for you to play with? Okay, one day only. Many people ask me, Leo, what do you do with all this stuff when you're finished with it? Well, this one will go down to the local charity shop where I live. My Christmas train from last year went there as well. So will that train there. I've really got no purpose of these after I've shown them in the video. So will that train there. I don't really need that one as well. But I will keep the Easy Tech one here, the Black Canyon Express, because I've got some more train comparison videos lined up for next year. And before it goes to the charity shop, I will clean out all this melted chocolate. What do you think of that Christmas train with the lights? Ready to give this Christmas train a run? Let's do it. It's cheap and cheerful. It's a Black Canyon Express with Christmas lights on it. I spoke about this in the video. I thought, well, I'd better do it. It's one thing saying it, it's another thing coming along and actually doing it. That's what I've added. It's a $25 set of 100 lights, which have the battery pack is actually right there on the tender. And I've put a couple of flashing ornaments on the train. I've got one at the front there, as you can see, and I've got one up the back there, a bit like a warning to the train coming up the rear. Sorry for the Duracell brand there, but these are the sort of lights that I like to do this with, because they are battery powered, and I could have put those stars on instead of the flashing lights. Oh, what's that? Uh-oh, the bomb is back. The bomb is back. Well, there's one very cheap and nasty Christmas train. At least we can de-Christmas that if we want. It can become a normal train. And here's a light fairy we found. Wow, look at you. Got your lights on. Well, you could run around the suburb very Christmassy like that, couldn't you? Do you think you like those lights on for Christmas? Yeah? You feel like a tree? No. Hey, you're taking your lights off. Why? It's only for trees, is it? Okay, sorry about that. Anyway, we'll get back to looking at the Christmas train. Sort of thinking there's a squeaky wheel in this train. The grounds are wet because we had a massive storm. This is the same day I did the review of all the trains. And after that really, really hot day, we had this absolutely incredible storm. Oh, look at Thanner up the front there, looking fine and dandy, driving the train. What do you think? Is that Christmas train or is it a bit of a joke? I like the reflections I'm getting for the fact that the ground is all wet as well. And for me, if I was going to do a Christmas train, well, I'd probably do it like this. I'd sort of prefer this than doing a dedicated Christmas train that always remains Christmassy. And sure, it's a bit rough and ready, but hey, sometimes you can get away with that at Christmas time. I'm sure of it. Yeah, that might catch on. Well, he's grabbed a bit of blue tack to hold the battery pack down, just like I did with my train. You're going to give it a spin? You're going to see this one working? Okay, let's see if it goes. There you go. First time on YouTube, I hope. Christmas digger. What do I feel is an impending disaster about to happen? Uh-oh. This isn't very Christmassy, is it? Oh! You'll definitely never see that on anyone else's channel. Oh, I absolutely guarantee it. I have to admit, it's actually given me an idea for another video. Something mesmerizing about seeing that sort of action. Are you going to fix this train wreck? Or are you just going to leave it as it is? What are you doing? Another go at the digger? Oh, come on. We can't claim any more carnage here. Oh, digger's running away now. And it looks like the Christmas train is being put back on the tracks. Well, the train did get back on the tracks. We should always have a happy ending to these videos. Because people get angry. No, my boy's excited with that Christmas train. You know, we should say another goodbye because we sort of had a double ending again in this video. Wow, look at that digger covered in Christmas bling and flashing lights. Would you like to have a digger like that for Christmas?
Yeah.
Have you got a special message for the people who watch our videos?
Yeah.
What is it?
Happy Christmas.
That's a lovely thing to say.
Dad, do I have to meant to say Merry Christmas?
Nah, Happy Christmas will do. Happy Christmas, everyone. You're looking forward to looking at these Christmas trains? That's why it's so hard to make videos here. Are you kissing that train? I just saw you kissing it. Is that right? $69 train there. What is it? 44. Oh. Take two. Oh no, someone's put Santa's sign on the track. What's going to happen? It could be a derailment. Or it might just push it aside. Looks impressive. I suppose I can see the difference. We're one less carriage. We've got a bit of, oh, blah, blah, blah. Do again. And we've got a problem today. We've had giant ants attacking us, playing with the trains. And if I bring the train around slowly and... Oh. The K-Mart train, I think it's pretty well priced for what it is. Here comes Santa Claus on the Black Canyon Express Christmas train! Yay! Very squeaky wheels, isn't it? Have to get some Santa grease onto that. It's got covered in sparkles and Christmas bling now. Would you have loved to have a digger like that for Christmas?
Yes.
Have you got a special... Oh... Would you have loved to have a digger like that for Christmas?
Yes.
Have you got a message for the people who watch our videos?
Yes.
What is it?
Toy.
No, it's meant to be Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
We'll do another one, okay? Have you got a special message for the people who watch our videos?
Yes.
What is it?
Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Christmas.
Can you remember this? Two words. Merry Christmas. Okay? Take whatever.
Nothing.